After horsepower, headlights are on the top of the list where performance is never enough for bikers. This video is on how to change the headlight bulb, and then we will test and compare the performance of the new bulb. To begin with, we have to remove both the screws marked with yellow circle. This is the first one. And here goes the second one. Just below the headlight assembly are the two bolts which holds the entire assembly. We don't have to remove them, we have to just loose them. And this applies to both the bolts. Just loose them by few turns and leave. With the bolts loose, now we can tilt the headlight assembly forward for easy access to the bulb. Here is the H4 socket which we have to remove by pulling it out. We have to be careful and pull by holding the socket and not the wire. Next in line is the dust cap. This rubber dust cap helps in keeping the headlight dome clean from inside. And it also helps in protecting the headlight from external dirt, dust and water. Most of the LED bulbs will have a fan or a heat sink at the rear for heat dissipation, which might need to eliminate this dust cap, which is not a good idea. Yes, we can cut and modify the dust cap, but make sure this air vent remains as it acts as an exhaust and prevents water condensation inside the headlamp. As we can see here, the inner part is absolutely clean and free from dust as compared to the external part. Cleaning the outer part of the dust cap helps in keeping the bulb and the contact points clean, and it also prevents the vent from clogging up. Here I am using the Nikavi carburetor and parts cleaner, which is safe on the rubber parts. You might have seen me using this cleaner before on this channel, and this is not a paid promotion, but I must say this thing effortlessly cleans without causing any damage to the rubber or metal parts. Here we are taking the stock bulb out, and this one is from Phoenix and it is rated for 12 volts and 60 by 55 watt power consumption. The performance of this bulb can be seen on different comparison videos on this channel, and I must say it performs really well for a stock bulb. Here comes the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus, which claims 130% brighter light. This one again has the same consumption of 60 by 55 watt, so this is completely stock replacement bulb with no need for external relays or fuse. So here goes our new bulb. Let's get a different camera angle for better understanding. After the bulb is plugged in, we have to put the retainer clip back to its place. This is the same clip which was removed while taking the old bulb out. After fitting the dust cap and connecting the socket to the bulb, finally the headlamp assembly comes back to its place. Secure the headlamp assembly by the two screws and don't forget to tighten back the two 10mm bolts after this. So it's time to test. First we'll test the stock headlamp that came from TVS, and here is the low beam where we can see the beam spread and the brightness. Now this is the high beam where usually the beam spread is narrow and the throw is longer. Now it's time for our new bulb, and this is the low beam from the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus. As we can see here, the beam spread is almost the same with negligible improvement, but the brightness is definitely better. The same thing can be observed on the high beam, just the brightness has improved. Now back to back we can see, this is the low beam from the stock bulb and this is from the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus. Now again we have the high beam, this is from the stock bulb and this is again from the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus. As we saw in the video, we cannot keep the expectations high from the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus, especially after upgrading from the stock bulb of the RTR 200. Again, we must keep in mind that the Philips Xtreme Vision Plus provides better brightness and a bit colder temperature from the same reflector housing and from the same power consumption without any need of elimination or addition of a fuse or relay. I would like to conclude by saying it's better, but not a significant improvement from the stock. Which brings me back to the words which we started the video with.